This is just one of those tutorials that everyone wants to watch because of how cool it sounds.
Slow motion?
Ooh. You can literally manipulate time as you wish. This is so freaking awesome. Alright, let's start before my mouth turns into a freaking wormhole. Anyways, did you like that new little intro that I put in? That was awesome, man. That took me a whole week to animate. It was totally worth it. It's awesome for this series. Man, I'm hyped for what's more to come. Now, I have a scene where this wrecking ball falls over and knocks over some boxes. When the wrecking ball collides with this area, there is explosion particles, the screen shakes, and it also zooms a little. Just little effects like that. And of course, a game is not complete without sound effects, so I added that in too. And that is all we are working with. You probably know where I'm going with this. Let's say I want to make the scene go into slow motion once this wrecking ball collides with the boxes, because I think it's gonna look sick, right? It's extremely easy to set up and use. I kid you not, it's one behavior. And not a lot of people know about this, so that's why I'm making this video. Almighty Set Time Scale, baby! I opened a behavior and there's a time scale value that is 100% by default. 100% is normal speed, 50% is half the speed, and of course, we can go faster. 200% is twice the normal speed, but for this case, I want to make a slow motion effect. I'm going to be using a number that's smaller than 1 because it makes the scene go slower, so maybe 50% would do. And don't stress about it too much, we can always adjust it later on. There is this duration input, which determines how long it takes for the speed to change. And you can make some cool effects of this, but I'm not gonna mess with that yet. So, I want this behavior to execute when the wrecking ball collides with the box area, so I will put it here. Of course, everyone will be working on their own unique projects, so just make sure you know where to use the behavior. Now, let's run our project. Ooh, that is sick. But you probably noticed that the transition felt a little too abrupt because it changed instantly. And maybe you wouldn't want that in your circumstances. So let's play with the duration and transition. I used a 1 second duration with the exponential out tween for the transition. It looks so much better. You guys should experiment with this behavior and see what you like. You probably notice how jittery the boxes look moving in slow motion. Since the project is now running half the speed, the physics engine is also going to run half the speed, but hyperPad remains at 60 frames per second, so of course it's going to look freaking weird and you probably don't want that. So if you navigate to the project settings, you can raise the physics refresh rate to account for this. So if my project's going to be running half the speed, then 120Hz is good. Why? Because the refresh rate is usually at 60Hz, and HyperPad runs 60 frames per second. So using 120Hz instead of 60 will make the physics engine render twice as fast. So in slow motion, instead of running like 30 frames per second, now it's rendering at 60 frames per second. So you don't see any of that weird jittering in physics objects. 240Hz seems extreme for this case, but it would work if time is going to be running 4 times slower or 25% of the original speed. And now, we have a cool little slow motion effect in our scene. And to top it off, I'm gonna go back to the behaviors and make it speed back up to normal after a second. But note that time is twice as slow in this case, so in reality, this will wait for 2 real-life seconds instead of 1 second. And yes, this behavior affects everything in the scene. That includes the timing, particles, everything. So just be aware of that when you're using this behavior, because if you want something to happen like at the exact timing that you want, then you have to take account of what speed the project's going to be running at. And here are the final results. Wow, that actually looks pretty sick. This tutorial was so fun. I want to keep making shorter tutorials like these, where I'll go over small features like this that not many new users might know. It just makes your project look cooler. I know, this is a short video. I didn't have much time to work on a tutorial at this time since I'm preparing to graduate school and I have two different academic competitions I have to worry about at my school, which is scary. But anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial and I will see you next time. Bye! Yeah, after all of that, I'm still gonna use the same old outro. What do you guys think? Do you guys want a new outro or do you think this is cool? I don't know. Just comment down below what you guys think and maybe I will consider it. Yeah, I feel like I put way too much effort into these videos. But hey, it's worth it in the end.